Hi guys, I'm Paula from Defend Survivors, which advocates for children reporting sexual abuse to be believed, protected, and defended. I made a post the other day on social media, and it went like this. It said, survivors don't need to forgive themselves. They need to realize they didn't do anything wrong. That post got a response. And what I realized is so many survivors have never been told the truth. And so I want to direct this video directly to the survivors. And I want you to hear the truth, that you were not to blame. People that responded to the post said that they think that this is something that survivors deal with silently. And I think that is very true. I think a lot of people silently hold that inside themselves, even if everybody else has told them they're not at fault, even if they've had counseling that tells them that. I think a lot of people hold it inside of them that there's something inside of them that they did do something wrong, or there was something about them that made it happen. Then they hold that responsibility inside them. We all do that. We all if ourselves to death. If this hadn't happened, if that hadn't happened, if I'd driven a different way, if I hadn't gone there that night. I think the reason that we do that is because we all just desperately want it to be different, right? We want something to have changed it so that it would be different and it wouldn't have happened. But we have to realize that the perpetrator is the one responsible. They're 100% responsible. If you didn't have a perpetrator in your life, none of the things that you did or didn't do or anything about you would have made a difference. You would not have been hurt if you had not had a perpetrator in your life. The truth is that whatever you did in that moment, during that time, it was the exact right thing to do because you survived it. So whatever happened, you made the right decision. No one has the right to judge what you did. Whatever you did was the right thing. If you're still in it, whatever you're doing is the right thing. No one has the right to judge because no one is the expert in your situation except for you. You're the only expert in your experience. No one can say what they would have done or what you should have done because they weren't there. You were. You experienced it. You survived it. You're living it. You're dealing with it. You are the expert in your experience. I think so many survivors live with thinking that there was something about them that made this happen. And I think some of that comes from the messaging that we give people. You know, we hear people talking about how the vulnerabilities and children that have risk factors to being harmed. So there's some children that are autistic that are more susceptible to being harmed, children that are not as assertive, children that are too assertive and will go up to anybody. Like all these things, they are not risk factors. They are not make you more susceptible. Those are things that the fact that a perpetrator would harm a child that's autistic shows how horrible that perpetrator is. It doesn't show anything about what's wrong with the child. There's nothing wrong with the child. There's everything wrong with the perpetrator. The perpetrator being in that child's life is the only reason they're susceptible, is the only reason there's a risk that they might be hurt. It is about the perpetrator, and we need to focus the messaging on the perpetrator and not on the child. There's nothing wrong with the child. And then we have victims growing up in their life feeling like there's something wrong with them, feeling like they were weak or they did something wrong or there was something about them that made this happen. And there wasn't. There was nothing about you that made this happen. There was everything about a perpetrator that chose to harm. Put it all on the perpetrator. You don't take one bit of the perpetrator's guilt. There's no guilt. There's no shame. There's no responsibility. You take none of it. It all goes to the perpetrator, 100%. Put it all on top of them and leave it there. You've been through trauma, and that's awful, and it does have effects. But you are not weak, you are not broken, you're not damaged. You're actually pretty darn incredible because you survived something most will never have to survive. You have skills, you used intelligence. Guarantee you, if we went back and we sat down and we looked at everything, we would sit there and go, that was brilliant. You're amazing that you were able to do that. You probably outsmarted a perpetrator who is much older, much more powerful, and you were smarter enough. You were smart enough to survive it. You are strong and you are intelligent and you did what most people never have to do. So if no one's ever told you the truth, I'm going to tell you the truth. It was not your responsibility. It was not your fault. there is 0% of the guilt, there's 0% of the shame that should be on you. None of it. Don't accept any of it. It is not for you. It never was. It is for the perpetrator. Leave it with the perpetrator. Don't let this lessen your guilt or lessen your shame. None of it. Push it away. It's not yours to have. You hear all the time, forgiveness is the way to healing. Well, maybe it is and maybe it isn't. Some people, it might be the way to healing. Other people, it's not. You don't have to forgive to heal. And you don't have to forgive yourself because you didn't do anything wrong. So instead of forgiving yourself, you need to realize I have nothing to forgive because I didn't do anything wrong. Forgiving the perpetrator might be something that's helped you. And if it has, that's wonderful. I'm so glad about that. But we should not be telling victims that they need to forgive to heal, because they don't. So many times, perpetrators make victims, survivors, feel like they're responsible for them. So I call it toxic empathy. Survivors can have so much empathy toward the other person that what they need anger. They need that anger to get out of that toxic empathy. They need to realize that they are angry. I heard somebody say the other day that anger is the part of you that loves you, part of you that says, this shouldn't have happened to me. So you don't want to drown in anger. You don't want to live in it forever. But sometimes anger is a good thing. Honestly, I would much rather you be angry at the other person than be angry at yourself, because you didn't do anything wrong and they did. And if you need that anger for a while to hang on to get yourself out of feeling like you're the one responsible for it, then there's nothing wrong with that. If somebody is saying there's only one right way to heal, that's not true. You know the right way to heal. Find the people that are going to support you in your healing the way you want to do it. This is your healing. You're the expert. Listen to the truth. You didn't do anything wrong. Put away all the guilt and all the shame. If you take anything away from this video, please know that you are not responsible for what a perpetrator did. They are 100% responsible. Don't take any of it. You need to take care of you, and we hope that you know how amazing you are. If you like this video, I hope that you'll subscribe and hit the bell to know when we make new videos. I usually make videos trying to get other people to believe the child, but today I really wanted to talk directly to the survivors, and I want you to know the truth, that you are important and that you are not to blame.